come and catch the vibe. Welcome to Easy Weekend.
It's Easy Weekend.
Cats can't see me.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the sit down. It's your guy EmEz. We back at it again. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit that bell for the notifications on all that good stuff. I got Funny Man.
What's up?
Rapper Man. Actor Man. TravQue in the building.
What's good, y'all? We stay humble and working over here.
Absolutely. Listen, I appreciate you when you came the last time. I told you I like the energy and the work ethic that you put forth. And now that you're moving over to music, how has that changed your life?
It's just another lane. And this song that I put out, Whose Man's Is This? You know the slogan. Hey, Whose
Man's is this? Yes.
So one time I was chilling and I'm like, what if I made a song to this? How would people like react to it? And the people have been giving me a lot of constructive criticism. Not everyone likes it, but majority of people love it.
I've heard it, and like I was listening to it with my girl Shay over here, and I was like, it gives me 90s Montel Jordan vibes.
Right, exactly.
And I was like, I could fuck with it.
Appreciate that.
Absolutely.
Definitely, and that's the vibe I want to give. I want to make it universal, so you know, the older generation and the younger generation can rock with it as well.
So the girl on the record, what's her name?
Letta J.
How did you find her?
Through my homie, my manager, Dez.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So now you've got the song together.
Yeah.
What is some of the feedback you're getting?
I'm getting great feedback. Yeah. I've heard that I should have made it, you know, shorter. But a lot of people are saying what you're saying. It's getting that 90 vibe.
Yeah. Absolutely. TravQue's in the building. To sit down with your guy, EmEz. Now, is there more music to come? Is this just a one-off? Like, are you just dibbling, dabbling? No, how far or how serious are you taking this music then?
So, since I put this song out, a lot of people have been saying you need to continue and do more music.
You look like an R&B nigga, though, God. I'm like, I ain't lying to you. Pause.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I mean it. You okay. I'm a married man. There's nothing sweet about me. You're an attractive guy that seems that you're smooth. So, it feels like it goes into that R&B lane, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Not that you're singing, but it feels like that's the lane you would be most comfortable in.
Right.
So what lane do you see yourself in?
I'm definitely not a singer. I'm not a singer, you know. But maybe I should try that out, you know?
Talk to the ladies,
yeah,
bro.
I'll talk to the ladies, definitely.
Mm. Okay, so, but after the music, so what are you acting, correct?
Yes. I have a movie out on BET. It's still spinning right now called Swag Inc.
This nigga.
Check that out.
The first time he sat here, he was just an Instagram funny nigga. Now, let me a couple dollars, guy. You good?
I got you.
See, niggas sit there like, nah, baby, don't count my pockets. Travel real nigga.
Nah, you've been showing love since day one, bro.
I have to.
Like, it's only right, you know, to reciprocate that energy.
And I guess you can talk to people that know me. When I see somebody, I'm like, oh no, he's about to catch one. And I caught you, pause, at the perfect time, because it was like, not enough people had seen what I had seen,
right?
But now that we sit here the second time, the world has seen what I seen, and you about to be out of here with the music, with the acting, and everything else to do. I don't want to say I'm proud of you because it feels like I'm the big brother. Like, no, but you doing your thing, and I appreciate what you do for the culture and how you're doing it. It's amazing.
I appreciate it. You're Haitian, right?
Yes.
There's something about Haitians. Y'all just know. My best friend, Dez, and my manager is Haitian.
See?
So it's like, you know, y'all always have good energy. I can't eat the griot. What's the griot?
Griot.
The griot is pork, so I can't eat that. But everything else is amazing.
Nigga. Have you had pecans?
No, I haven't.
Are you into spicy food?
I am.
Oh.
I got it.
Ask Dez to bring you some pecans. Put on some rice, nigga. You'll never, your life changed.
I'm going to do that. And he was telling me something like, they were telling me something about babaku too.
Oh! Yo. Oh! That's that hard liquor. Listen, if you want that, we'll shoot that babaku.
Yeah.
It's the sit down, TravQue's in the building. It's your guy, EmEz. Anything else we need to know about what's going on in your life?
I'm just staying humble and working, man. I appreciate you even bringing me up here again. Like I said, check out the movie Swag Inc. is on BET right now. Every time it plays, people will tell me and they tag me to it. I'm like, yo, I appreciate that. They're still playing.
How does that feel for you, though?
It's an amazing feeling. Coming from Instagram and coming from a social media platform, making that transition onto television.
You know what I'm saying? That's amazing.
It's a blessing. And I appreciate it every day. The story that I even got that role.
Go ahead, let me hear about it. Let me hear about it. Yeah, okay, you got plenty of time.
I got invited to the BET Viacom building for a screening.
Oh.
And after the screening was done, Marcus Houston was the executive producer for the film.
Okay.
And I didn't know he was into like executive producing. So my bro and my manager Dez, he was like, let's go holler him. Let's go let him know you act. I said, I doubted myself. I'm not even gonna front to you. I said, he's probably gonna look at me as an Instagram comedian or social influencer. So I said, I'm gonna leave it alone. I'm walking out. My bro Dez, who was Haitian,
Shout out to my nigga Dez.
One of these. Yo, go talk to him.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And I was like, all right, all right. So I was like, what's up, Marcus? You know, I act. He said, do you have everything that you may need? I said, I have a headshot, a reel, and a resume, and I can send it over. He said, send it over. I sent it to him that same night. A month later, he hit me back. He actually DM'd me. He said, we have a role that we want you to audition for. Ooh. With BET and Viacom. So I sent him my self-tape, and he said, everyone loves you. You got the role. So I
just like that. You didn't even have to go in.
I didn't have to go in. I sent them. They loved the self-tape. Oh, so wow. It was like, that was an amazing feeling. So I say that to say this, never doubt yourself.
Never.
And if an opportunity is there and it presents itself, go for it.
Yo, TravQue is the epitome of that grind and go get it. You made it happen for yourself, fam. When I tell you, it brightens my soul to see you flourish. Because I remember and I'm like, yo, this nigga funny as shit. When he put the heart on the one girl, said, now walk away.
See, I always think outside the box. You know, with the now walk away from me, I got bars.
Yes.
Whose man's is this? I like that. It's everything is outside the box, you know? Mm. And I'm just staying in my own lane.
Listen, your lane is about to be a lane that people are going to want to get into because you're doing great things out here. And God has touched you with the hand of God. You about to get it, fam. Thank you for coming by. Let him know how to follow you, how to be a part of your wave, because I'm pretty sure everybody already know what the fuck he doing. But let him know again.
www.travque.com. That's my website. All my social media is the same. TravQue. That's TravQue. Stay humble, stay working.
Facts. Play my man's song right now.
Whose man's is this? I need to know.